For me, the thing that's most different about dancing for Ballet Black than other companies is there are so few dancers. There are only 8 of us, so it's kind of a group of soloists. We all get to perform so much. We are all on stage and featured quite often. Also, each year we have 4 new choreographers, 3 or 4, and it's all original work made on us, which is quite exciting.
I was inspired to set up Ballet Black because I wanted to know what would happen if you created an environment where black dancers weren't the only black face in the room. And it started as a ballet class, and then it grew out of that into the company that you see today, 15 years later.
At the Barbican, I'll be performing a piece by Arthur Peter. It's a 15-minute duet / pas de deux. It's very challenging. The music is by Steve Reich, who is one of my favorite composers of all times. So it was exciting for me to know that he was the composer, and therefore that changed a lot of like things for me, because I love his work and I just wanted to give it all. And being part of the piece is very nice and very challenging at the same time, because the music is very hard to understand, which makes things exciting. But it's very great, it's an amazing piece, and it's very challenging, it's very hard, it's very exhausting mentally and physically. So I'm very grateful to be part of it, yeah.
So our new season is at the Barbican, and we have 3 ballets to perform. One is a restaging of an audience favourite from 2012 called Storyville, choreographed by Christopher Hampson. And it's the tale of Nola, this very naive farm girl that goes to the big city and gets into all sorts of trouble. And what's exciting about restaging it is that in 2012 it was a 30-minute piece and everybody loved it but thought it was too short, so we were able to come back to the choreographer and add some new scenes to it. So we've expanded it, we've got quite a lot of new cast members in the piece, and we're really looking forward to staging it at the Barbican. And the first half ballets are by Arthur Peter and Christopher Marney, who we've both worked with before. Arthur's ballet is a very interesting new pas de deux, and Chris Marney, who's worked with us on about 6 other ballets in the past, is making a new sextet. So it features an enormous piece of silk, which is a big challenge to rehearse with, and it's about one man and his journey through different relationships. Arthur Peter has chosen a piece of Steve Reich music called Drumming Part 3, which is I don't know how many musicians using xylophones just drumming away on them for about 15 minutes straight. It's really, really challenging music to count, to rehearse with, but it sounds incredible.
From what I'm told and kind of remember, my mom took me to see the Dance Theatre of Harlem, and they were doing Firebird, and I just remember being really small and sitting on phone books and just seeing someone up on the stage who kind of looked like me. You know, at 5, dance wasn't even in my head yet at all. You know, I just saw someone doing something beautiful. And now that I look back on it, that kind of connects the dots to me being where I am today, as far as being so free to dance and moving to New York when I did at 18 years old, and just taking certain steps, you know, seeing someone who looks like you kind of makes you feel that you can do it as well.
I'm very excited for us to perform at the Barbican. I'm really looking forward to all of it. Being on a bigger stage, engaging with quite a different audience to what we're used to, and just to collaborate with such a well-known venue. I think if you've never seen a ballet before, Ballet Black is a really good starting point, because the bill has 3 different ballets, 3 very different pieces of music from 3 very, very different choreographers. So there's going to be something on the bill that you like.